Hello, my dear students of ECS 3342 Winter 2022. This will be our second but last lab exercise for the semester. However, it does introduce to you something that's actually quite worth learning. So I would like to just give you some brief introduction about what you can really expect from this lab. In some way, it's actually quite challenging because you have to learn about how to use the Roden tool to do some manual proof, to construct the proof tree, and also apply certain inference rules that we did speak about in the lecture. But to really use it in the tool, you will have to make sure you have to spend enough time trying to put the different pieces together to understand exactly what's being argued. That's something that was explained in the tutorial. But let me walk you through the instructions and also point to you the reference that you definitely want to consult with when you actually study this tutorial. In overall, there will be about 90 minutes of tutorial video you have to watch, but somehow I'll explain to you it's actually quite condensed. Quite much information is really put in, and there are certain implicit assumptions about how the logic should be put together, which I didn't explain quite much in the tutorial videos. But of course, you still got your chance to ask me questions during the office hour or Q&A or just appointment. Just reach out to me. But I believe the tutorial videos are still pretty much self-contained. So that's something I'm quite confident. But anyway, let me go over with you the instruction. I don't really mean the first video to be very long. I just want to walk you through the idea. All right, so this will be lab number two, and there still be no submission required, right? As we said in the beginning of the course. And it will be released on Monday, March 21st. And it will be, you can think about, you should really expect to complete it with full understanding on the last day of the semester. I believe April 11 is a study day. You want to make sure you actually finish that in time. Otherwise, our exam will come very soon after that. And let me just highlight to you, I don't need to read over the instruction, you should, okay? Assumption about using remote lab for Roden, if you need to, just make sure you use the latest version 3.6. And you can feel free to install the Roden 3.6 on your machine if you want to. The instruction is already here. And what we are doing for this lab over here is quite an interesting exercise. We're going to do some refinements for the so-called binary search, which you definitely learned from the earlier data structure course, maybe EECS 2011, or maybe even earlier. I'll let you read it, but basically what we're gonna do in the tutorial videos is to show you how you can, rather than using the automated theorem prover in the Roden to prove things, we're going to see how we can, as humans, to interfere about the proving process manually. That's something we want to see. And you will definitely see some very familiar proof steps that we're going to see, that we're going to use in the tutorial videos. And what will be the expectation? Let me just make it clear, because I don't want you to panic. Okay. Number one, as we noted earlier, this course is going to focus more on the sequence proofs that we cover in the lecture. So you definitely still want to prioritize what we cover in the lecture. But for this lab over here, let me give you a little bit idea about what you should really focus on when you study that. Definitely, some contents that's covered in lab one and lab two, they will be covered in the exam, the coming final exam, which is pretty heavy for you to really get right. You want to focus on learning about the logic of the proof steps, especially I explain very much carefully about how you can apply the modus tollens in the tutorial video. And you want to make sure you understand the visualization and make sure if I give you something similar, in a similar proofing scenario, you will be able to apply the similar steps. And you want to, well, it's really for your knowledge, so you would know there's such a tool for you to actually manipulate inference rule. So maybe beyond this course, if you ever have to use maybe some tools for conducting proof, Roden definitely can be one choice. But in this course, we didn't really go too deep into it. But at least you know this is such a tool as introduction. And what can be covered about in the exam, right? So these are the two points I try to put over here just for you as a general guidance. But you definitely want to make sure you understand about how exactly the conceptual ideas of planning the proof strategies, and also about whenever you have some hypotheses on the Roden tool and what's really the goal being proved, and how we can transform the hypotheses into different ones. So those are the points you want to focus on. Okay. Of course, in the exam, we wouldn't ask you to do mouse clicks about the applying the proof steps. So you want to make sure you focus on the right spot. Right. About resources, it's just the same as before, so I don't need to waste your time. And here are the steps about how you can get started with the lab. You're going to download this particular starter project from the e-class. import it into your Rodan 3.6, pretty much like how you import Java project into Eclipse, similar, because Rodan somehow is based on Eclipse. And so this will be, I haven't really changed the link at the moment I record this video, but when you look at it in your PDF instruction, you will see the correct link. Not the Rodan intro, but Rodan prover. Okay. And some tips over here, you can definitely look through them. I'm not going to bother you now because they will only make sense to you once you dive into the details for the tutorial videos. And also some clarification about the video. The reason that we need some clarification is as follows. Right? Let me tell you this. The tutorial videos I'm going to supply to you for this lab over here, I didn't record it currently. I recorded that about 7 years ago in year 2015 when I was teaching the same course. However, all the math, all the logic, and most of the details are still relevant. Nothing has been outdated. The only thing that might be a little bit different is when you actually see some discrepancy, very minor, about certain outstanding sequence or outstanding proof obligation, it can just be discharged automatically. But in the older kind of proof, in the older version of the prover, which I used when I did a recording, it could not be done automatically. So that's the only difference. I already wrote it down, documented in very detail, so you can definitely take a look. And another thing is a personal side note. You will see that when you watch the current Lab 2 tutorial video, you can easily identify it's actually me. But since as I said, it's about me 7 years ago. So maybe the way I present the materials and my pace, maybe talking speed and my pitch may be quite different from what I'm speaking now. Maybe this the kind of style you have been used to throughout the lecture. But that's okay. It's still really made by me. If you got any questions about the tutorial videos, you can definitely reach out to me. Otherwise, I believe they are pretty much clear and self-contained. Finally, I would like to point to you this document over here, which you can only get access to in the videos 2A and also 2B. I spoke about some visualization about about planning the proof strategy. So this is a PDF version for that. You can definitely go over that. That's something you would have already seen once you go over the video. Right? Again, this will be your lab number 2. That'll be the final lab exercise for this course. Hopefully you enjoy it and learn something from that. And reach out to me if you got any question. And starting from the next video, you will listen to me from 7 years ago about a tutorial video for using the Rodan prover. All right, enjoy. And then I'll talk to you later.